Okay, let me know if you relate to this statement or have ever said it before. I need to make more time to draw. Yeah, we've all been there.
Whether you're feeling a bit rusty or simply want to make more time to practice, may I invite you to be students together today? It's never too late to get started or brush up on some skills. So feel free to grab your sketchbook and let's go for it together. First things first, let's pick a topic. There are endless topics to study, but on today's agenda, some anatomy figure drawing. Throughout art school, an essential course we took was drawing from life, specifically studying the human anatomy, the human body, and there are different techniques on how to do so. Masters of the Renaissance like Michelangelo, Raphael, Leonardo da Vinci, all included this in their practice. Whether they're drawing or painting the figure, they really took time to study the anatomy of the human form. A complex yet exquisite subject, and this practice carries on through today. And figure drawing was reintroduced in art school, and this involved sitting around in a circle, the model was in the middle, we all had easels and big giant drawing pads and just drew what was in front of us. And although we don't have a live model today, I want to recreate this feeling and this session together with some references I prepared right in front of me, which will pop up on your screen as well, but the overall point is to set up your subject in front of you. I continue to attend in-person sessions, so if you're able to, I definitely recommend it as well. But in today's episode, I just want to bring the ability for us to do it together, wherever you are. When any class or practice is in session, you are prepared, all your attention is at your practice. So if you're practicing along with me, try to place the screen right in front of you and elevate your drawing pad so you're looking right directly up and studying from that. Also, maybe try to challenge yourself with a larger sheet of paper so you get a little more movement in your arm. If you don't happen to have an easel at home, don't worry, just simply lean your paper pad against your table and just create a little bit of a tilt. Lastly, prepare your favorite drawing tool or something just as simple as a pencil. Get comfy, make sure that everything is nice and steady for yourself. You want to be as comfortable as possible and make sure there are no distractions. These are free references that I found online, which I'll link below, but I'm really excited to guide you along together with me. So here are just some quick tips before we begin. Today's intention is not to get into too much detail and hunch over. We want to sit up straight, keep our posture, and draw from the shoulder. I mentioned this in my warm-up practice video, but it's often overlooked, and I'll just keep gently reminding you. So what we don't want to do is focus too much on one little area. Our goal is going to be to capture the whole figure, and guess what? There will be a timer. This will also be a two-part session. In this part one study episode, we're gonna do 7 1-minute poses, and then we're gonna do 7 3-minute poses. And then the next one, we'll do 2 5-minute poses, 4 10-minute poses, and then I'll guide you through a whole gouache painting of how I study the figure. Now that we're all set up, let's get started with today's session, which is all about loosening up, nice and freeing, getting rid of perfection. And the best way to do that and challenge yourself is with a quick 1-minute gesture drawing. No details, just capturing the main action. And that's right, 1 minute on the clock, so we have no time to overthink, but just intuitively draw. Here's our first pose. Let's capture it with the time set, and let's go. I love practicing through repetition, and gestures are a great way to remind yourself to loosen up, really study the action and form. It may feel a little pressuring at first with such a time constraint, but that's really all an illusion. Just have fun with it and enjoy it. I want to show you that messy sketches are okay, and it's all part of the learning process. And the beauty about it is that it's super versatile and great for all levels. Before I move on to the other gesture drawings, just want you to know that the first few that you do are supposed to feel like weird and awkward. They're gonna feel intense because you're doing something in 1 minute, and the goal here is just to keep that hand moving. You're capturing the main gesture, you're capturing the main line of action, and they're not supposed to look perfect. Get rid of perfection because this is just an exercise for you to move your hand and just capture the whole figure as one. So as I'm finishing this demo, the first few drawings that I like to do in my practice are really just warm-ups. Learning to get loose, learning to make mistakes, get messy, slowly get in your flow state, Don't think about composition, just begin and get your hand flowing. These will be a bit sped up for time's sake, so feel free to pause the video at any time and make your own timer as well. So while doing these practice gesture drawings and just getting the flow of things nice and quick, if you're not able to get things down in 1 minute, perhaps you need to draw just a little bit smaller. As you go on with your drawing session, you're going to learn that there are different things you're aware of. You're going to realize things like, oh, maybe I should draw smaller. Maybe I should hold my pencil a different way so that I can work quicker and get the flow in quicker. Just take note of anything that comes up and pivot if necessary. I'm just using some graphite now, and I love using the blending stump to get in some quick values, and it honestly saves time, especially when you're doing such quick studies. Gestures can be challenging only because we usually seek perfection, detail, and this is a great way to undo that and let go of that. So I also have to remind myself to practice these sometime because they're really freeing and gets different artistic muscles moving. So don't be afraid to get messy and don't be afraid of the challenge at all. It's really great to also practice different types of references, different poses, facing forward, facing back, some a little bit more still, some a little bit with more action. I'm all about variety, so that's why I'm presenting you here. But once again, reminding you of the intention today, just some little drawing drills to sharpen up some skills. And remember guys, repetition is key. And what we're also doing today is building up some self-discipline. As I'm drawing and finishing up this last pose for our gesture session, I'm smudging with my finger, I'm focusing on different angles, and within myself and my own mind, seeing how I can push my little strategies and do something a little bit new with each drawing. This is your time to experiment. It's a totally safe space, so don't be afraid and just go for it. All right, let's see how many we have. Looks like the first 7 are complete.
All right, first page is done. How are you holding up there? If you're practicing with me, just know that the gestures are super freeing. They're gonna feel weird.
But also they'll feel really good at the same time. Take a moment to look at your drawings. Give yourself a positive comment. Even if they're messy and loose, there's still beauty in them. Take it as a nice warm up and a fun exercise. Now you're gonna set your timers to 3 minutes and we'll do another 7 of those.
Oh, let's go for it.
As I'm getting ready to set up for the next one, a quick word from today's sponsors, Squarespace. I think we can all challenge ourselves and teach ourselves anything. And as a full-time artist, I've built my website with Squarespace. Their all-in-one platform and award-winning templates make it super easy for you to do so. You can manage your online portfolio, you can even set up your own shop. The fact that the way Squarespace templates are designed are super mobile friendly, which makes it easier for anyone to shop from any place, right from their mobile devices. A great tip from something I learned when I was setting up my website, I love that I was able to test out the templates, drag and drop some images to see how I like them looking. They have many templates like the Brine family, which is super versatile. You can customize it, play around pressure-free, and then you can see how you like the design. The best way to do that is to head to squarespace.com to start your free trial. And when you're ready to launch, go to squarespace.com/JessCarp for 10% off your first purchase of a website or domain. For these 3-minute drawings, I'm using a charcoal pencil. I have to be honest, I don't normally grab this tool, but sometimes grabbing the tool that you don't normally grab is really great. Another tip I'd like to mention is make sure you're glancing at your reference and back at your drawing paper. At your reference, back at your drawing paper. Actively observe your model or your reference. This way you're applying your hand and eye coordination together for your skills. And I like to try as many as possible until I feel confident and strong about it. And although I've been practicing for quite a while, there's always something new that I can learn. And I hope you've been enjoying learning together. A pattern you may notice while you're drawing and you're doing more and more is that they get better and you notice some new things. So just be mindful of that and know that with each one, you're learning something, you're progressing. So just keep your head up and enjoy the process. At this point in my practice sessions, my music is blasting, I'm singing along, I'm completely in the zone. I remind myself to keep loosening up and have fun with it, because we can be hard on ourselves. I'm also alternating between the blending stump and my pencil. I can also keep things interesting by switching from graphite or charcoal. Again, at the end of the day, just enjoy the supply you're using. It really doesn't matter, which is why keeping it super simple sometimes really helps. And just like I mentioned in my creative habits video for 2023, the point is to just show up. Just get started and get going. While you're drawing, if it helps, check out some other examples of figure drawings or gesture drawings. Open your mind and build your creative library, because although there are endless possibilities on how to study and practice, this is just one of them. I also really enjoy breaking things down into diagrams and shapes, and I'll show some of those examples in the next video. So make sure you hit those notification bells so you don't miss it. I've been reading many of your comments on the Creative Habits video. First, I'd love to say thank you so much for all your support and awesome comments. It's such a beautiful thing to be able to reach you guys all over the world, and the fact that we can all support and uplift each other through the comment section is even cooler. So I want to try something new where I take a comment and shout it out from previous videos. Today's featured comment is from Roxana. Thanks for commenting and for your support. She mentions that committing to the page is also one of her creative habits, and she's reminded to be a bit more patient and not to think about the finish, which is really great because we often can think about the end when it's really important to just focus on the moment and your practice. A huge thank you and a huge hug right back. Patience is always a great reminder. For this next and final pose, once again with some variety, let's do a laying down pose. A little bit of a challenge, but nothing we can't do. Something I learned from this practice today is that it takes a few times to get a little bit warmed up. Life can take over sometimes, our day-to-day lives can get a bit hectic, and we can feel a bit rusty. But once we just start, once we get going, once we put in just a little bit more time throughout our day, especially to up our skills or do something that we love. It's like riding a bike. We just catch on, we keep going, and believe it or not, we end up improving through the process. 1% better than you were yesterday. Strive for that and you're already on the right track. There's a time for finished pieces, but today I wanted to shine light on the beauty of messy sketches, loosening up and enjoying the process, because without this practice, it's way more difficult to get to the next step. If you enjoyed this session, we have a real-time Patreon live session, so you can check that out if you're interested. And as mentioned, there will be a part two, so make sure you pencil in our next practice session together by hitting that subscribe button and notification bells on, because part two will be all about building the form, finding shapes, stylization, and a yummy bonus gouache painting of the figure.
Before we go, it's time for a quick reflection.
Grab the drawing you made and ask yourself two questions. One, what is successful here? And two, what can you apply and do better next time? Feel free to also share it in the comments below, and then we can apply these in the next video. Once you've reflected, that's it, you did it! Give yourself credit, thumbs up this video if you found it helpful. It really helps to spread it to more and more people who want to practice as well. If you want more practice right now, I have two videos up top, some great simple warm-ups, and some more gesture drawings if you're on a roll here. Stay creative, and I'll see you in part two.